Hi, this is Edmund. So today's video is how bookies cheat. So have you ever been wondering how bookies actually cheat most of the punters around the world? Okay, so I'd like to share with you a scenario that I encounter every single day. Okay, what happened is this. I have a strategy where we will bet either like a first half over 0.5, right, or goals, or either that second half you bet like over 0.5 goals full time. Okay, so in this scenario, let me share how bookies work. So imagine it's the first half, right? I'm anticipating that there are goals being scored because the odds tell me that there's a high chance that goals are going to be scored, and then the odds movement as well as the goal scored as well as the actual match action, as in like the possession, the shots on goal, etc. So we collaborate, when we combine all this statistics and information, we feel that there's going to be a goal. So what we do is we bet over 0.5 goals. So what a lot of people don't realize is that whenever you're watching any live telecast, right, through your cable TV, right, it's not really that live, meaning the information is actually delayed. So meaning if a match is being played supposedly at maybe 7 p.m. so at maybe 6:58 or 6:59 the match would already be started. Okay, so that the bookmakers actually have probably a 60 to 90 second time frame whereby they know what's happening in advance, right? Because early on I was sharing with you this cut siding video, right? So but soccer is kind of more complex. Soccer, you can hardly do the cut siding because the bookmakers already anticipated that kind of action. Okay, so how they cheat is this. Imagine because they have a 60 to 90 second head start, they know what's going to happen. So whenever you imagine if you are betting first half over 0.5 goals, and then what happened is there's a goal being scored, right? You would have won the bet if you are betting first half over 0.5. But then the bookmakers, when you have a winning ticket, right, or winning bet, ticket means bet, huh? So when you have a winning ticket, the bookmakers will tell you, sorry, when you place the bet, the goal was already scored, and that's why your over 0.5 goals bet in the first half has been voided. Okay, so let me give you another scenario. Okay, same scenario, you're betting first half under 0.5 goals. Okay, and then there was a goal that was being scored around the time that you actually placed the ticket, right? But then what happened is when you're betting over 0.5 goals, they will tell you, sorry, the goal was scored before you actually enter the bet, and that's why your winning bet is not accepted. But then when you bet under 0.5 goals, the moment the goal is being scored, they will accept your losing ticket, and then the bookmakers will tell you, sorry, your bet actually came before the goal was scored. You get what I mean? So basically it's a show-win situation for the bookies, right? Winning tickets are not accepted and losing tickets are all accepted. Okay, this is what has been happening to me. I don't know what is going on with you guys. Feel free to leave any comments and to share some of your experiences on how have you been cheated by your bookies, right? So feel free to leave any comments, right? So this is my daily occurrence, right? Okay, so let's do a simple mathematics. Okay, I do not know what's your bet size. Okay, in capital management, let me give you the best ratio for capital management. Imagine if you have a betting account of $10,000, right? What you should be doing is you should be placing only 20% of your betting account size to a live account, right? Meaning all the bookmakers like Betfair, etc., right, or Singapore Pools. So what happened is, if your fund size is $10,000, for online bookmakers, you should only deposit maybe $2,000, right? Every single bet should be 5% of your online betting account, right? On your online live betting account, meaning if your online live betting account is $2,000, every single bet should be 5%, right? To sum it up, it's $100, okay? So every single day without fail, I'll have at least three situations whereby I'm being cheated by my bookmaker, right? Whether it's a first half over 0.5 goals or second half over 0.5 goals, etc. Right? Every day at least three bets like that, okay? So imagine we just need to have a odds at 1.90 odds, right? So meaning every day you have three winning bets that you're being cheated off by the bookmaker, okay? So let's do some simple mathematics, okay? So every single day you are being cheated off $270, okay? And that amount actually adds up. Over a week is actually $1,890, okay? And in a month is actually $8,100, okay? Because $270 daily, you multiply by 30 days, $8,100, okay? And that could be a pretty comfortable general manager's salary or director's salary, okay? And every day you're being cheated, because you've been cheated like one bet, two bet, or three bet, you hardly notice it, right? And you're at their mercy, okay? Let's calculate more, okay? So every year you're being cheated of $97,000, okay? And over a period of 10 years you're being cheated of almost like close to $1 million. Can you imagine? This is provided your account is you're still winning, you're still surviving, right? So imagine if you over this period of time you actually lost 200k over a period of 10 years, you could have been winning like $700,000, right? Over a 10 year period. I'm just giving a lump sum example. Okay, so how do you stop the cheating? First of all, you need to create a fair sports betting exchange, okay? You want to create a fair sports betting exchange that doesn't take sides, okay? And then you need to make sure that this exchange is actually using blockchain to enable real-time goal scoring. Because sports betting exchange, they are not taking any sides. So when you're actually betting with bookmakers, you're actually betting against the bookmaker, and that's why they will do their utmost to actually cheat you. But then for sports trading exchange, they don't care who actually wins, because they will be getting a 2% to a 5% commission from the winning party. Okay, and that's one of the projects that we're actually working on, which we are raising funds to the VCs. Okay, so basically if you're interested to be part of this project, please get in touch with me. Okay, this is my contact. And basically if you have any similar kind of experiences whereby you have been cheated by your bookmakers, feel free to drop a comment below and share your experiences. Okay, so I hope you enjoy this video. Thank you. Bye.